Hi guys, welcome to the new lecture of our series, and it is related to introduction of data pre-processing and data cleaning. So we'll first talk about the data quality and the need why we need to pre-process the data. So the need of pre-processing is because the data can be faulty, inaccurate, lack some sense, or maybe inconsistent. This kind of data can't lead us to a correct inference. So what we require is we need to pre-process the data and convert it into a suitable format along with the consistencies involved, so that the inferences which we take out from the data are correct. So we'll first talk about the data quality. So what are the measures for data quality? While talking about a multidimensional view, first is accuracy. So accuracy does means whether the data in the data set is correct or incorrect. Is it accurate enough to go with the inferences or not? Then we'll talk about completeness. Is all the data correctly recorded? All the fields are present, or some fields are not available, or some data is lacking? Then we'll talk about consistency. So consistency is like we have multiple files, and in some there is a modification, in some there is not. So identifying which value is correct is an issue. Like a salary of an employee is 10,000, which was previously 8,000. So in most of the record, the salary has been converted to 10,000, but some records or some other files are showing the salary to be 8,000. So the salary of the employee can either be 8,000 or 10,000 according to the record. So this is the inconsistency of the data. Then we'll talk about the timeliness. So the data needs to be updated timely in order to get the correct information. If it's not timely updated, then we'll be processing the data of the previous timestamp and we'll be putting it as current timestamp. So believability. And believability is how much trustable is your data, how much you are assured that you have recorded the correct data. Then we'll talk about the interpretability. Interpretability means how easily the data can be understood. Like the fields are of the data are conveying some meaning, and how easily the meaning of the field and the value is understood, it is termed as interpretability of the data. So we'll talk about now major task in data pre-processing. First is data cleaning. So data cleaning includes filling in missing values, smooth noisy data, identify or remove outliers, and resolve the inconsistencies. So we'll be talking about these points in detail, each and every point. So just go through it like an introduction, then we'll come into the details of each. Then is data integration. Integration is basically integrating the data from multiple sources, queues, files in a single place. Then data reduction. First is the dimensionality reduction. Dimensionality reduction basically means if we are talking about a state, then a city, then a lane, area, then a lane, then we move directly towards the state and we group together the data in terms of state, then our dimensionality of the data is reduced. Then we'll talk about numerosity reduction. In numerosity reduction, consider a student getting marks out of 100. So his marks will be in the range from 0 to 100. If we can map the marks 0 to 100 in the range 0 to 10, the numerosity of the data will be reduced. So this is numerosity reduction. Then we'll talk about data compression. Compression is basically reducing the size of the data, which can be done in any manner, that like the data can be mapped to some certain other values, then we will talk about data transformation and data discretization. So that will be requiring normalization and generation of concept hierarchy generation. So concept hierarchy generation is just like a parent-child class relationship. So now we are going to talk about data cleaning in detail. Data cleaning. Data in the real world is dirty. Dirty means that it is not 100% accurate. Lots of potentially incorrect data, which can be due to a faulty instrument, a human or a computer error, or it can be a transmission error while transmitting the data. Incomplete data. So incomplete data basically means that an attribute value is missing, or the data is lacking a certain attribute of interest, or only containing the aggregate value. Like instead of marks of each subject, if we are recording the overall total, then it is containing only aggregate value. Like consider an example where occupation, and we haven't given the value. So it is basically the occupation attribute don't have a value assigned to it. So it is basically missing data. Now we'll talk about noisy data. Noisy data is basically the data which is containing noise, errors or outliers. So consider the example where salary is minus 10. A salary of an employee can't be negative. So it's basically a noise, error or outlier. But basically here it's an error only. Then we'll talk about inconsistent data. So inconsistent basically means discrepancies in the values. Like if age is 42 and birthday is 3/7/2010, can the age be 42 or can the birthday be 3/7/2010? One of the value is incorrect and it is making the data inconsistent. So we can't surely say that this is the correct value or this is not. This is inconsistent data. Inconsistent data can be that rating was 1, 2, 3 in the earlier format, and in some of the formats we have changed the rating to ABC. So some data is showing rating 1, 2, 3, some is showing ABC. What we need to do? We need to map the values and make it consistent. And the other point is discrepancy with duplicate record. Like if an employee has two records and both are showing different value of a particular attribute that can be data of birth, it may lead to inconsistent data. Then it is intentional. Like consider an example where I have a field where I need to mention the birthdays, but in my previous data I have only recorded their age. So based on the age, if I fill in the value like Jan 1 along with that year calculated, so it is not correct data, but we are able to cope up with the existing limitation that where we don't have the actual date of birth, and we just make January 1 as the default date of birth. Now we'll talk about incomplete or missing data in detail. So data is not available many times, and many tuples may have no recorded values for several attributes. Like even when we go to some store for purchases, when they ask for a phone number, we prefer not to give the phone number. So what the field there suggests is a incomplete or missing data. So missing data may be due to some equipment malfunction, that the equipment has failed to record the data, or inconsistent or other recorded data. So because of inconsistency, we have deleted that data, or someone has not entered the data due to some misunderstanding, and certain data may not be considered important at the time of entry. Like we talk about the telephone, and we have not registered in the history and changes of the data. Like previously we didn't require it, now we are requiring it. We have modified the database, but we can't get the old value because we have not recorded that value. So missing data may not be inferred, or may be needed to be inferred. It depends on our requirement and the manner in which we require to deal with the missing data. So how to handle the missing data? Firstly, what we can do is we can ignore the tuple. It's usually done when the class label is missing while doing the classification. So ignoring the tuple means while computing, just do not make the computation while considering the tuple, just ignore it like it doesn't exist. Then the second option is filling the missing value manually. It is a tedious and infeasible job, but what you can do is you can just fill the data manually by some values based on the calculations, or you can fill in automatically with a global constant like a new class like unknown, or the attribute mean, basically the average of the values, and the attribute mean for the other option can be the attribute mean for all samples belonging to the same class, which is a smarter move because the samples belonging to same class will have similar attributes, and it is a better choice as compared to the upper choice, which is basically the attribute mean. And the other is, and the last and most important is the most probable value. It's based on some calculations and we try to infer what actually should be the value, and we just fill that value on that attribute. Now we'll talk about noisy data. So noisy data can be a random error or a variance in a measured variable. So noisy data is basically the data which is affected and has some error added to it. So incorrect attribute values leads to noisy data, which can be due to some faulty data collection instrument, basically error of the instrument through which we are measuring, or some data entry problem like the keyboard has a problem, like when you press 4 it enters 5. So that is basically a data entry problem because of the hardware, but it is not data entry problem, it is the problem of faulty instrument. Data entry problem is like I say enter 45 and someone enters 54. It is a data entry problem. Then there are data transmission problem. Data transmission problem are basically while communicating the information gets noisy. Then there is technology limitation, like we have a scale of recording and we cannot exactly record a particular value. Then there is inconsistency in naming convention as well, and other data problems which require data cleaning are problems of like having duplicate records, like same rows are multiply present, and some incomplete data or inconsistent data. So how to handle noisy data? First method is binning. First we sort the data and partition it into equal frequency bin. So we have partitioned the data in ascending order into bins. Now what we can do is we can smooth the data by taking the mean of the bin, or taking the median of the bin, or basically shifting the inside data with bin boundaries. Then we can do regression. So we can just generate an equation of the data as a regression function, and then we can smooth the fit. Another example is clustering for the solution of handling noisy data. So what clustering does is it detects and remove the outliers of the data. And the last point is combined computer and human inspection. So it basically does is detect suspicious values, and it is even checked by humans for dealing with possible outliers. So data cleaning as a process. So first step is data disappearance detection, which requires the use of metadata, and then we'll check the field overloading. Then we'll be taking the uniqueness rule, consecutive rule and null rules to identify whether there is data discrepancy. And there are some commercial tools also available like data scrubbing and data auditing, which will be able to detect data dependency. Then the second step is data migration and integration. So data migration tools are basically tools that allow transformation to be specified. Then there is ETL, extraction transformation loading, which allows the user to extract the meaningful information, transform it into suitable form, and load it into a required format through a graphical user interface. The integration of two processes is iterative and interactive. With this, we come to the end of our introduction to data pre-processing and data cleaning. I hope you will be getting what I am trying to teach over here. In case of queries, you can mail me at utsav@gwca.ac.in. Kindly go through the textbook as well and be safe. Stay safe. Take care of yourself. Thank you.